Hey, it's Sue and... Oh, fuck the... Hey, it's Sue in the restricted section. Today I'm going to do a review of my June TBR jar pick, which was the Kite Runner by Khaled Hosseini. And warning now, if you love this book and are going to get upset if someone says bad things about it, you might not want to watch this video because I didn't like this book that much. I really wanted to like it, but I just didn't. So let's go. So if you don't know what this is about, it follows a boy named Amir, and he lives in Afghanistan, and he's of a higher class family, and he's friends with their servant Hassan. And then something terrible happens that completely ruins their friendship and changes their lives forever. Then the book follows Amir as he's grown up and then sort of trying to redeem himself from this event. Where to start with this? I didn't hate this book. I didn't think it was terrible. However, I don't really have much good things to say about it. I feel like it's always easier to pick out what you dislike about a book than what you like about a book for some reason. I guess I'll just start from the beginning. The first thing about this book that really was getting on my nerves was the very obvious foreshadowing in leading up to this thing, that this terrible thing that happens. It seemed like almost every chapter in the first like quarter of the book, or however long it takes for this to happen, had some sort of obvious sentence at the end. Like, let me just find some, because it was starting to really annoy the shit out of me. Chapter 1 ends with the sentence, "I thought of the life I had lived until the winter of 1975 came along and changed everything and made me what I am today." So obviously, something's gonna happen in the winter of 1975. The second chapter ends with, "Looking back on it now, I think the foundation for what happened in the winter of 1975 and all that followed was already laid in those first words." Again, something bad's gonna happen in the winter of 1975. And then the third chapter ends with Amir saying, "I snapped at him, told him to mind his own business. Rahim Khan had been wrong about the Mean Street thing." So Amir is gonna do something bad, obviously. And then the fourth chapter, not so much. It does say, "Because suddenly Afghanistan changed forever." But it was just, I mean, there was more than that, I'm sure. Because it got to the point where I was like, good God, I get it. Like, something terrible is gonna happen in the winter of 1975. And there was also, I remember more than once it would say something like, "But that was the last time I would see Hassan smile like that." So it laid it out pretty clearly that something terrible is going to happen to Hassan in the winter of 1975, and Amir's gonna do something bad. So, and the book even starts, "I became what I am today at the age of 12 on a frigid overcast day in the winter of 1975. So it was just like hitting you over the head with it. And that was a theme, I feel, throughout the book. Not the foreshadowing, but just like hitting you over the head with things. Like, I feel like the author thought the reader was an idiot and needed everything spelled out for them. Because he even, like, explained the symbolism at times, and it was just, yeah, that drives me nuts whenever an author over-explains things and makes the reader, like, it made me feel like he thought I was too stupid to understand what was happening if he didn't spell it out for me, you know? Like, he was not subtle at all. So that bugged me throughout the book, but it especially drove me nuts at the beginning with that foreshadowing. Oh, and another thing that bothered me about the writing was the random Farsi words just like sprinkled throughout. I thought that was really annoying, and like, I get that he was wanting to, you know, bring in parts of their culture and things like that. And I think that, you know, including their salutations to each other and maybe like important words and things in Farsi would have been great. But he just like would throw in random stuff. Like, table, in front, you know, like just a random word all throughout. And it just like tripped me up while I was reading, and it seemed pointless. Like, I'm not going to remember any of those words. What was the point in putting any of that in there? So I also found that really annoying. Also, the just things about the plot just seemed very contrived. Like, things were too perfect, and it wasn't believable. It just, yeah, it was too many coincidences that worked out, you know, to fit in the story perfectly. It didn't seem like a believable story. Also, the villain, I hate villains that are just one-dimensional and like, or characters at all, really, but like, when you have a villain that is just evil, just an evil sociopath, there's no complexity to them, you're just meant to hate them. And that's how the villain was in this story, and I just generally don't like that. I don't think it's interesting. I feel like it's kind of lazy to create a villain like that. He literally says he's a fan of Hitler at one point. It's like, how much more clearly could he be about, like, hate this guy? Him right here, just hate him completely, you know? Like, I don't know. I just found it kind of ridiculous. And then later, this guy who says he's a fan of Hitler has never heard of the term ethnic cleansing, which I'm like, you're not that big of a fan then, are you? And then I think my other main problem with the book is that the main character, Amir, he's not very likable, but I feel like I was supposed to like him by the end of the book, and I really still didn't. And I also didn't care about him that much. I found him to be kind of boring. So there's this whole section in the middle that's just about Amir, and I didn't really care. I would have gladly read more about Hassan and where he ended up, because he was a delightful character, I thought, but you don't really see him until later in the book, and then you just hear about him. That, I mean, it took me a long time to get through this book, which was ridiculous, because this book does not, it should not take that long to read. It's not that long. The writing is pretty, like, fast, easy, nothing super complex to the writing, so it should have been a quick read, but it took me at least a month to finish this book, because I just didn't want to pick it up. I just found myself not compelled at all to pick it up, and I think it was mainly because I didn't care to read about Amir. And then also, like I said, I do think you're supposed to like him by the end of the book, and I mean, I didn't hate him. I didn't think he was, like, a horrible, terrible person. He did some terrible things, but I didn't hate him, but I still didn't like him that much, and I didn't care that much about him. And one thing that really did piss me off, which, okay, this is gonna be a spoiler, so if you don't wanna hear it, I'm gonna hold up the book while I'm talking about it, and then I'll put it down when I'm done. Starting now. But a thing that pissed me off is that when Amir goes back to Afghanistan and learns, you know, of Hassan and his wife's death and about his son and all that, he still doesn't agree. Like, Rahim Khan, I think was his name, asked him to go, you know, get Hassan's son and bring him back. And Amir is like, hell no, I'm not doing that. That's dangerous. I could die. Until he learns that Hassan was his half-brother, and then he's like, oh, okay, I'll do it now. Why did it matter that Hassan was your half-brother? Like, Hassan was your best friend. He would have done anything for you. He did do anything for you. You were a complete and total worst friend ever to him as a kid, and you've regretted that your whole life. And then yet, you still wouldn't do that thing for him or his son until you learned that he was your half-brother. Why did it matter that he was related to you? And, you know, I know that it changed his whole outlook on, you know, his relationship with his father and his father's relationship with Hassan and etc., learning that, but it still, to me, shouldn't have mattered. I feel like he owed that to Hassan whether Hassan was alive at that point or not, you know? And it still took learning that Hassan was his half-brother for him to do it. And that kind of made me angry. I was like, you're still an asshole. Like, you're still an asshole. So I do think that he redeemed himself a bit at the end, but I didn't feel like he ever completely redeemed himself to me in my eyes. So there you go. Spoilers over. Yeah, so I don't know, this book just, I didn't emotionally connect with it either. I think probably partly because, like I said, I didn't really care that much about Amir. Before reading this book, everyone told me like, oh my god, that book made me cry so much. Like, oh, just like ugly cried reading that book. And I barely cried at the end of this book. Like, one tear streamed down my cheek because of one of the characters. I won't say, if you've read the book, you'll know who, but one of the characters that doesn't show up till toward the end of the book, just what he had to go through. That got to me. But before that, up until that point, I didn't cry at all. I don't know if I just wasn't in the right place to read this book, or if I'm just turning into an automaton or something, I don't know. But it mostly didn't really affect me that much. And then on the, you know, back to the parts that were not quite believable, this is gonna be spoilers again, so again, I'm gonna hold up the book, but starting now. There was things like the slingshot. Why would the Taliban have let that kid keep his slingshot? Like, they wouldn't have taken that away from him. And then just like the, has shot him in the eye, just like his father said he would, you know, it was just like too, you know, too perfect and not believable. Yeah, so that was just a specific thing I wanted to point out, but spoilers over again. Yeah, so I ended up giving this 2 stars because, like I said, I don't think it was like the worst book ever, that it was terrible, but it wasn't that good in my opinion. Like, I don't get it. I didn't get it. So that's my unpopular opinion on The Kite Runner. I'll be links below where you can find myself and Megan other places on the internet. If you haven't subscribed yet and you don't hate me for this review, please do. And thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.